I say good morning to each and every one of you. And welcome to this act of worship on this, the fifth Sunday in Lent. The opening hymn, hymn number 466. As we join together as one in our separate spaces, I want to encourage us, as the song just said, to place everything, all our cares, all our anxieties and fears, in God's hands. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Venite.
Show us the valley in which
Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The appointed psalm is Psalm 130.
From the Word of God, written in Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 to 14. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones, and say to them, 'O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you, and will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live. And you shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I had been commanded, and as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. Then he said to me, mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say our bones are dried up and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you back to the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people. I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live, and I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 6 to 11. To set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the spirit is life and peace. For this reason, the mind is set on the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot. And those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh, you are in the spirit, since the spirit of God dwells in you. Anyone who does not have the spirit of God, of Christ, does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, through the body, though the body is dead because of sin, the spirit is life because of righteousness. If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will give you life to your mortal bodies also through his spirit that dwells in you. The word of the Lord.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. What kind of life are you living? What kind of lives are we living? Have you ever really thought about it? I mean, seriously thought about it? Putting aside our sometimes perfect view of ourselves, have you ever taken a close look at the life you live or that you have been living? As much as we are encouraged each Lenten season to do some introspection, to take a look into the mirror that reflects our lives, how many of us actually do it? Lent after Lent, year after year, many people just go through the motions. We may decide to fast or do whatever we traditionally do during the Lenten season. But we often do these things simply out of habit. And so we do not focus on their meaning or the potential benefit to our spiritual and overall growth. This year needs to be different. Even if we didn't start off with much of a focus on it, I want us to take the rest of this Lenten season seriously and focus on our journey. We're all aware of what is going on in the world right now. But rather than just focusing on the negatives of it, I want us to embrace the opportunity that COVID-19 has given us to renew ourselves and our world. We are now no longer running here, there, and everywhere. For our physical well-being and that of others, we are taking a step back. A step back from the physical aspect of life. And so I want to encourage us to use this time to look within ourselves for the benefit of our human and spiritual growth. As I say this, I know that some of us may be afraid to actually do it because it may mean facing realities that we have repressed and that lie in our unconscious. But if we are to grow and to achieve the abundant life that Jesus offers us, we must make this step and journey inwards. Throughout life's journey, we have all faced challenges. And even in this journey inwards, we will face them. And probably one of the first ones is the challenge of being still. Truly one of the most difficult things in this fast-paced world is to be still, be quiet. It is one of the most uncomfortable things for us to do. We long for the noise of life. We long for the busyness of activity to drown out the deafening sound of silence and the fear of facing what is inside of us, who we truly have been. But today, I want us to begin to put that fear aside and allow Holy Scripture to speak to us. I want us to allow the words of Paul in the second reading to be the mirror into which we gaze to see our reflection. Paul, in his words to the Romans, spoke of how people live their lives, whether according to the flesh or according to the spirit. As we look into the mirror, as we gaze upon our mirror image, we must ask, whose ways are we reflecting? The ways of the world or the ways of God? Hour after hour, in every sphere of our lives, we are pressured to conform to the ways and values of the world. At work, we are tempted to do underhanded things to get ahead. Because in this world, you often hear, look out for number one. Look out for yourself at all costs. Or we may even hear the worldly proverb of, do unto others before they do unto you. These, along with so many other things, have become the unwritten but accepted ways of the world. And as Christians, we are constantly being pressured to do the same. Right now, as you hear my words, you may be thinking to yourselves that you have been able to resist these things. You have not engaged in any of those behaviors. You have been able to keep yourself above those things. But even with that being the case in our minds, as we all look into the mirror, we still need to ask, are there other areas in our life where we have not been the type of person the Christian is to be? This is truly important for us to recognize for ourselves. And so we must start by asking ourselves, how am I treating the members of my family? How am I treating my neighbor? How do I treat strangers? How am I treating the members of my church or my club? Do I show everyone respect? Do I share the love of God? Are my actions and behaviors of the spirit, or are they of the flesh? Is my focus on the world, or is it on God? It is time that we truly look within ourselves to see where we are and where we have been. And if and when we recognize our shortcomings, we need to be strong enough to admit them to God and seek His forgiveness. Seek His help to be better. The thing is, however, we must not seek His forgiveness in a moment of fear and piety brought on by COVID-19, and then return to our bad habits when things get better. No. No matter the circumstances, we must seek to continue on the Christian path of love, doing the good that God commands us. As we start this journey, we can borrow the words of the psalmist in Psalm 51, verse 10, and pray for ourselves, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me." The words of verse 14 of the first reading today emphasizes the real possibility of this. When the Lord said, "I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live." Indeed, God can renew us and give us the strength to face and overcome the temptations to do those things which we should not. The temptation of reverting to our former ways of life. No matter our past or even our present, God is able to bring about a change in our life. And He can breathe His Spirit within us and give us new life. My friends, do not ever think that you cannot change. Even as we may be struggling right now with the realities of our actions, we need to ask the question, even though I stumble, can I not see the good within me? Yes, this journey of life is hard, and we are often tempted to do things that are wrong and that will hurt people. But my friends, God can give us the strength to withstand those temptations. The love of God and the light of Christ dwell within all of us. And so we have within us the ability to press on and do great things. We have been called to display reflections of God's love in this world. And indeed, we can do it. But for us to truly live lives that reflect the goodness of God, we must allow Him to lead us. Because as the collect for today says, only God can bring into order the unruly wills and affections of us sinners. It is through His grace that we will be led to love what He commands and desire not our wills or the wills of the world, but desire what He promises. And so I pray that as a community of faith, as Christians throughout our various communities and countries, we would indeed use this time to allow the Spirit within us to be renewed, so that the love of God that is within us could be clearly seen and easily shared, so that through us, through our love, through the lives that we live, God would continue to touch, bless, and heal His world.
Thank you.
the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The suffrages.
Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them, now and always. Day by day we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you alone can bring into order the unruly wills and affections of sinners. Grant your people grace to love what you command and desire what you promise, that among the swift and varied changes of the world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessings through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray together the prayer of dedication. We thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our path, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. This time we will now have some notices.
Good morning. We extend a warm welcome to everyone who has tuned in today
I trust that we have all been able to take the challenges of the past week in stride. This morning, we say happy birthday to those celebrating this week. Rupert, Marion, Kareem, Nakia, Shamari, Leonie, Pamela, Magdalena, and Greville. And we wish for Marcia and Stephen a happy anniversary. Though challenging, let us continue to pay attention and heed the social distancing advice issued by the government. I wish for you a wonderful week.
Let us pray. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a blessed and enjoyable remainder of your day and your week as well.